Before the judging night of Miss Universe 2010, Venus Raj of the Philippines had already made a significant impact during the pre-pageant activities, which contributed to her being a strong contender. National costume show, Venus Raj showcased her cultural heritage with a stunning black and white Filipiniana designed by Colombian designer Alfredo Barraza, which was well received during the national costume show. Media presence, she had a strong media presence, including a photo op at the iconic Welcome to Las Vegas sign and a media tour in Los Angeles, which helped in building her profile before the main event. Charity auction, demonstrating her commitment to social causes, Venus participated in an auction for the benefit of the Nevada Cancer Institute, where she auctioned items including an elegant pearl necklace and boxing gloves signed by Manny Pacquiao. Public support, the overwhelming support from Filipinos based in Las Vegas and the backing of Binibining Pilipinas Charities Chairman Stella Marquez Araneta, despite previous controversies, added to her momentum. Training and preparation, her early training, which included using rice paddy dikes to develop her distinctive palapal walk, and her participation in local beauty pageants and oratorical contests, laid a strong foundation for her performance in the pageant. These activities and her overall preparation showcased her dedication and readiness for the competition, making her one of the favorites to win the crown. Miss Philippines Venus Raj, going into the final night's Miss Universe pageant, was favored to win but stumbled badly when she failed to answer this question.
And finally, all over the world today, newspapers were splashed with pictures of this woman from Mexico who won the Miss Universe pageant in Las Vegas. But we were interested in a different contestant who was asked the question about the biggest mistake in her life. A question asked in a lot of job interviews. Is there a right answer? Sharon Alfonsi reports.
She was favored to win, expertly negotiating platform heels and a bikini. And then came the question, that question that stopped her in her stilettos.
What is one big mistake that you've made in your life, and what did you do to make it right?
Thank you so much, sir, for that wonderful question. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening, Las Vegas. You know what, sir? In my 22 years of existence, I can say that there is nothing problem that I have done in my life, because I am very confident with my family, with the love that they are giving to me. So thank you so much that I am here. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Philippines.
Her answer was pretty much a non-answer, no answer, no crown. She took fifth. Reflecting on Miss Philippines' performance in the final Q&A round of Miss Universe 2010, what might have been an ideal response that could have secured her the crown? In the glittering world of pageantry, where every step and word can tip the scales of fate, Venus Raj's journey to Miss Universe 2010 stands as a compelling narrative of redemption and self-discovery. Her path was not paved with the usual fanfare but was marked by a stumble that caught the world's attention, an oversight in her birth certificate that led to her dethronement. Yet, it was this very mistake that could have been the key to unlocking the Miss Universe crown, had she harnessed it during the final question round. Her story is a reminder that while beauty captivates the eyes, it is the depth of our stories that captures the heart. The question posed to her, what is your biggest mistake in life and what have you done to correct it, was not merely a query, it was an invitation to unveil the depth of her human experience. Reflecting on our challenges is not just about recounting events, it's about engaging in a profound introspection that reveals our resilience, our capacity for change, and our growth as individuals. It's about understanding that our missteps are not failures but stepping stones to greater heights. So, what could be a winning answer to the final question given to Venus Raj at Miss Universe 2010? She could have won the crown that day if she cited the challenges she faced immediately preceding the Miss Universe 2010, which news already created a stir in the pageant world and thus some awareness with the judges and audience. How she made it to the Miss Universe stage after her dethronement by BPCI, the National Pageant Organization, could be her best answer to the question given her. Had she been quick in mind, she could have cited her mistake of not correcting any discrepancies in her birth certificate before joining the national pageant. Followed by the fact that after her dethronement, she put in persistent efforts to reclaim her crown to correct her mistake. If only Venus Raj had taken the opportunity to reflect on her journey to the Miss Universe stage during the final question, she might have said something like this. Owning our mistakes is the first step towards growth. Not long ago, I was dethroned as Miss Universe Philippines. My dream was almost taken away due to inconsistencies discovered in my birth records that raised issues about my nationality. Recognizing this, I took immediate and persistent action to correct that mistake that led to the reinstatement of my title. It is with this spirit that I aspire to carry the Miss Universe crown, to inspire and encourage others to overcome their challenges and realize their dreams, no matter the odds. Thank you very much. This response would have showcased her ability to overcome adversity, learn from mistakes, and emerge stronger, all of which are qualities befitting a Miss Universe. It would have resonated with the judges and the audience, who were likely aware of her story through news preceding the international pageant, and could have potentially swayed their final decision in her favor. For Venus, acknowledging her oversight could have demonstrated a remarkable level of self-awareness and maturity. By articulating the actions she took to correct her mistake, assertively reclaiming her crown and advocating for accuracy and diligence, she would have presented herself as a beacon of perseverance and integrity. This level of reflection and the ability to transform adversity into a learning experience is what gives a pageant contestant's answer its substance and depth. It's the answer that wins the crown, and Venus had the perfect opportunity to illustrate that. In the high-stakes moment of the pageant's final question, the power lies in the contestant's ability to connect her personal journey to universal themes of struggle and triumph. It's about painting a picture of oneself as not just a beauty queen, but as a human being who has faced life's trials and emerged victorious. This understanding of oneself is invaluable, for it equips a contestant to respond to questions with authenticity and conviction, resonating with the judges and the audience alike. Venus Raw's fortune during Miss Universe 2010 could have indeed been different. A thoughtful, reflective answer rooted in her personal challenges and the lessons learned could have showcased her not just as a contender, but as a true embodiment of the Miss Universe ethos, confidently beautiful, with a heart forged through overcoming life's hurdles. It is this narrative that could have swayed the judges and etched her name in the annals of pageant history, as Miss Universe 2010.
You just watched a video production by Mr. Pageants. If you like this video and have any suggestions, please like, comment, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next video.